After the Second World War, there was an urgent need to understand the major labor market changes related to Canada's transition to a peacetime economy. This is why the Labor Force Survey, or LFS, was developed. Today, the survey is just as important. The LFS is Statistics Canada's largest and longest-running household survey. Approximately 56,000 households across the country participate every single month. This large sample means the LFS can provide reliable data for different parts of the country and for specific groups, such as youth or recent immigrants. The LFS estimates of employment and unemployment are vital measures of the health of the Canadian economy. For this reason, the LFS is the only household survey with mandatory participation. Changing technology is a key part of the LFS story. In 1945, data was collected on paper in face-to-face interviews. In the 1970s, interviewers started doing some collection by telephone and began recording data on computers in 1994. Survey participants were first able to use a web-based questionnaire in 2015. The survey content has evolved too. Since a major redesign in 1976, the basic methods haven't changed, giving us more than 40 years of uninterrupted data. But questions have been added over time. The LFS now covers a wide range of topics, such as wages, union status, and work absences. It can help us understand how the labor market is affected by economic and social changes or events, such as recessions, the aging population, or even natural disasters like floods and forest fires. Governments, businesses, and social agencies use information from the LFS to make important decisions that affect the day-to-day lives of Canadians. For example, billions of dollars in employment insurance benefits are transferred to individuals every year, partly based on regional unemployment rates provided by the LFS. For nearly 75 years, Canadians have been participating in the LFS and helping provide high-quality data on the country's labor force. What will the next 75 years bring?